your FX. Coming at you on a holiday Monday. Bank holiday in the UK and Memorial Day in America. We're going to keep it short and sweet today. Won't be trading much. We don't like to trade when there's no liquidity and most of the participants are taking the day off, but let's just take a look at some of these charts and see what we're thinking. Overnight, euro went a bit higher with news out of Italy that they may go for a technocratic solution in their government. This looks like a fade to me. I think there's still going to be a mess there, and even if they go for a re-election, the chances of them getting a normal government or a non-populist or a non-Northern League solution seems quite low. So if you see euro yen up towards 129.30 today, especially on a low liquidity move, it's a fade. We're still bearish euro yen. Haven't even made a new daily high today. I recognize it could easily squeeze through this 128.60, but certainly 129 and 129.50 are fades as far as we're concerned. Let's take a look at cable. Silly little move that last hour in cable. We did not participate, and we're not even going to recognize it as real. The last hour before a 3-day weekend in New York, someone printed 93 in cable and closed kind of 98.9. The same strategy we're going to use this week as we did on Friday. We'll be watching closely to see if this 133.05 or 133, the figure, breaks. If it does, we are expecting more downside. The news out of the UK looks bleaker and bleaker. They are digging themselves one massive hole. The latest nonsense about European Court of Justice and not following, not accepting their rulings, and how this is going to affect the legal system in the UK over the weekend, and the number of criminals that may seek asylum in the UK. Whether this is even true or not, it almost doesn't even matter. It's just piling on more bad news. So we do expect this sterling to keep moving lower. So 145 the figure in sterling yen, and 133 the figure in sterling dollar. These are key elements. What else? Euro dollar, just like euro yen, we've kind of squeezed up here. This could easily move back up onto the sort of high 117s today and really be kind of still meaninglessly bearish. The fade looks like sort of 117.90 to 118.30. I don't even know if we're going to get up there. And just also, just as a reminder, you know, holiday liquidity today, so be careful. Dollar CAD continues higher. This is an important moment, this 129.99 or 130 the figure area. Crude is getting crushed still. Down at $66. Another 2% today. Markets caught long crude. We traded this so poorly, Christ. We're short at 70.20. Anyway, market short crude, and a lot of us are going to be chasing it now. I mean, we're not chasing it, but we botched it. We took profit way too early. Crude looks like it's could easily just plummet all the way down to $60. Don't pretend to understand what the hell's going on. I mean, I understand what's going on there, but don't pretend I can trade it well, so. Anyway, DollarCAD 130 is interesting. It would be more interesting if it wasn't holidays everywhere. But then even more importantly, 131.26. Keep in mind the Bank of Canada interest rates are this week. So, stuff to think about. So those are the three charts that we consider important for now. Again, today's a day where we're going to have lunch with friends and enjoy ourselves. We're going to come back tomorrow ready for action. But we'll keep a little cute little eye on the markets just to see if there's any exaggerated moves today, which I doubt there will be. With that, I wish you all luck. If you are going to trade today, maybe you're on the continent. And I will not see you at the New York Open today. I'll see you tomorrow at the European Open. Good luck, people. Ciao.